exciting watching those Olympic trials. I, for one, am excited about the Olympics, and hopefully it all goes well. All right, let's tune into our local weather here. Let's take a look at Surfline Morro Bay. It looks like we did have some sunshine out there. The marine layer really is going to be stubborn at the coast as we head into the week. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. Here's our Be on KSBY photos. This one's from Jeremiah off of Old Creek Road in northern parts of San Luis Obispo County. Good shot of those hay barrels there and the dry vegetation across California. This is MC Chavez's view out in Cayucas, and this is a great idea of the trends we're about to see at the coast. The marine layer, that June glued, is going to persist as we head into this week. Let's take a look at those temperatures right now. We're still looking at those low to mid 80s for much of the interior valley. Paso Robles is 75 degrees right now, 69 degrees in San Luis Obispo, 68 degrees in Santa Maria, 68 in Lompoc, 77 in Santa Ynez, 66 in Isla Vista and Santa Barbara. So we are going to see a cooling trend, and this is a great snapshot of what I'm talking about. Paso Robles is 13 degrees cooler than this time yesterday. We saw scorching hot temperatures last week, and we're already seeing a huge difference here on the Central Coast. It's about 6 degrees cooler in San Luis Obispo compared to this time yesterday. So we do have low pressure that's going to be spinning off the coast of California. That's going to move northeast into our area here over the next couple of days. So increasing onshore flow is going to strengthen, and then also the overnight marine layer is going to deepen, really bringing those misty and cloudy conditions for the coast here. This is a look at our microclimate forecast. So you can see that the marine layer is going to be pretty stubborn along the coast, making for some overcast days. Does look to burn off, especially for those interior valleys and coastal valleys, but again, it could be lingering over the next couple of days for the beach area. So we're not going to see a whole lot of sunshine there. It may burn off in those afternoon hours and we could see some clearing, but for the most part, looking at partly cloudy skies for much of the area. Our winds are actually going to be on the calmer side as we head into the next couple of days as well. We could see gusts up to 25 miles per hour, that southeasterly flow into the area, but nothing going to be triggering advisory levels here. So that's good news, especially as we're starting to see some more of those fires pop up. The one along Highway 101 in Lompoc, this is actually going to be good for those firefighters. It is dry, it's still hot, but again, we don't have those high or strong winds there. Here's a look at the day planner for the beaches. You're looking again at those partly cloudy skies in the upper 60s. Coastal valleys, we're going to have some clearing there in the mid afternoon, reaching those low to mid 70s, and the inland valleys are still going to be in those 80 degree temperatures with sunny skies. Here's a look at the area forecast for tomorrow. 79 degrees in Paso Robles, 74 in San Luis Obispo, 70 degrees in Santa Maria and Lompoc, and 74 in Santa Barbara. Now, as we head over to the north coast here, you're looking at those mid to upper 60s, 65 degrees in Cambria, 64 in Cayucas, and 65 in Morro Bay. In the Five Cities area here, we're going to be a little bit warmer in those upper 60s, some areas seeing those low 70 degree range. And in the Santa Ynez Valley here, looking at those upper 70s to low 80s. So take a look at this extended forecast, because the coolest day of this week and the cooling trend is looking to be Thursday, dropping to those upper 60s and low 70s for much of the area. But the cool is not going to last very long. Take a look at Paso Robles. We are back in those triple digits by this weekend. Nina.
All right, Megan, thank you.